Hi everyone, and welcome to another macOS related video. In this one, I'll try to give some answers to a frequently asked question in the comments on some of my previous videos. I covered earlier how to install macOS on unsupported hardware for macOS Big Sur, Monterey, and Ventura. Now, a valid question that pops up is, how is that actually performing in comparison to the latest supported version on the same hardware? Maybe the lack or difference in performance was a good reason for Apple to drop support on certain hardware models. So, in this video, I'll be running a series of benchmarks and tests on two Mac systems where I have both the latest supported macOS version and the latest unsupported macOS version, Ventura, installed. Let's see if there is a real difference and if you should maybe avoid upgrading to a new but unsupported release, even if it's possible to get it running. I can already tell you that I was genuinely surprised by the results, and I'm glad I went through the effort to test this. But first, a bit about the setup I have for this. I will be using this late 2013 iMac and this late 2012 Mac Mini. Both of these have macOS Catalina as the last supported version by Apple. The Mac Mini has a slower CPU and lacks a dedicated GPU, so we can consider it a lower-end model. The iMac, on the other hand, is the faster one and does have a dedicated GPU, the GeForce GTX 780M. This GPU needs patching to work properly with Ventura, so I'm curious to see the impact of that and the difference it might make. As I mentioned, I have both of these prepared with macOS Catalina, which is installed natively, so it'll open core, and that's also how I will boot it. And I also have the latest version of Ventura booted through open core. Any necessary patches for the OS to work properly on this hardware under Ventura have been applied. I also have Windows 11 on both of them, but that's for a later video where I plan to compare performance between Windows 11 and macOS. Make sure to subscribe and enable notifications if you don't want to miss that. In terms of benchmarks, I have the following lined up. For CPU and GPU performance, I will use Geekbench 5 and will run both the CPU and compute benchmark. For disk and I/O performance, AGA system test. For CPU rendering and 10-minute stress test, CineBench R23. And for day-to-day workload, BrowserBench in Chrome. Because I also wanted to test something more real-life, I'll do some audio processing by doing noise reduction, followed by an export on a larger file in Audacity. And for video editing, I will render a small project in 4K in DaVinci Resolve. In the end, we will compare the results and hopefully see the impact, or lack of that, when running an unsupported macOS release on your hardware. I also did want to run GFX Bench as well, but unfortunately this tool does not support macOS older than Big Sur. That alone would be a good enough conclusion of this video, as unfortunately more and more software will stop working with Catalina, despite the hardware is still doing fine and is perfectly capable. Let's start the first test, the CPU test in Geekbench 5. I will show you on one system how I started each test, but I went through the exact same steps on both machines in both Ventura and Catalina. Then, while the test is running, I will try to display the progress side by side. Not sure if that will always be clear, but what we are really looking for are the results, of course. Also, it should be noted that during these benchmarks, I'm running the screen recording in QuickTime and will record individual clips per test to avoid too much overhead. Nevertheless, this overhead should be equal for each test, so we still can compare the results. So, the first test is finished. Let's have a quick look at the results from that. Looking at the result for the iMac, the numbers are slightly higher in Ventura than in Catalina. And the same goes for the Mac Mini actually, where the difference is pretty significant. I really didn't expect to see such a large difference. At least not in the advantage of Ventura. Next test is the compute benchmark in Geekbench 5. This will mainly rely on the GPU and drivers for it. So I'm curious to see what influence the patches for the Nvidia card in the iMac will have. Here, the numbers seem to be in favor of the supported version, for both the Mac Mini and iMac. The difference is not really big, but still. Something that I'm also surprised with is the big difference in performance between both machines. I expected a significant difference, but this is really a lot. We're talking about 4 to 5 times faster here. Time to test disk or better SSD performance, as both of the machines are equipped with an SSD. For this, I will use AGA System Test with a 4GB file size. Again, we can see slightly better results on Catalina, but the difference is really small here. I would say these results are as good as equal, taking into account some possible variance in the results. The next test is with CineBench R23. This will test the rendering capabilities and mainly tests multi-core CPU performance over a longer time. If any problems with cooling or throttling, they should come to light here, but different OS versions should not really have an impact here. As with the first test, the results are in favor of the newer and unsupported version again, with quite a big difference even. As this relies heavily on the CPU, this basically confirms what we saw in Geekbench. Really surprised about that. Now something a bit more lightweight, BrowserBench. I typically run this test twice, as caching seems to result in a slightly higher score for a second run. The results are a bit confusing. We see a clear win for Ventura on the iMac, and a slightly worse but similar score on the Mac Mini. Not sure what is the reason for this, and I don't really think we can make any conclusion from this, to be honest. Now to the more practical testing, and I will start with Audacity. I have the same large audio file prepared in all cases, and generated a noise profile of the first 10 seconds. Now I will do a noise reduction and see how long it takes. The faster, the better in this case, so a lower time is better. The difference on the Mac Mini is again as good as nothing, and is well within the expected error of my test method. And also on the iMac, I would say performance is just equal. The second test with Audacity is to export the same audio file to .ogg. Exactly the same time on the Mac Mini. For the iMac, the difference is slightly higher in the advantage of Ventura. The final test that I will do is with DaVinci Resolve 18. For each test, I open the same project, which has a few 4K clips edited together. The source clips were copied to the desktop beforehand. I will export the clip in 4K, and here again, faster is better, so a lower number means a better result. For the iMac, the difference is minimal, considering this is only 11 seconds on 5 minutes. For the Mac Mini, the difference is a lot higher, and to my surprise, again in the advantage of Ventura. That was it for the tests and benchmarks I had lined up. In most tests, the performance between Catalina and Ventura, and so latest supported versus new release, was very similar. Sometimes a small win for Catalina, sometimes for Ventura, all within the error range of my not-so-exact testing method. That is, with the exception of CPU performance, apparently, as both the CPU test in Geekbench 5 as the results in Cinebench were largely in favor of Ventura. And that's not at all what I had expected. If there was one thing I had hoped from this, it would be that Ventura would at least perform similar, which seems to be the case, but that it would really outperform the last officially supported release was really a surprise. It's quite difficult to test the experience and feeling of how smooth an operation system feels in real life. But these numbers are confirming what I have experienced using macOS Ventura and in general unsupported versions of macOS. So, as a conclusion, less performance doesn't seem like a good reason why you shouldn't upgrade to Ventura, even if your hardware has long been out of support by Apple. It would be interesting to see in the comments how your experience is with this. Thanks a lot for watching, I hope you have enjoyed this video, and if you did, I'd appreciate a thumbs up. If you like this type of content, feel free to subscribe and enable notifications. Thanks again and hope to see you back here soon.